We've made it to Friday. I hope everyone's having a good end of your week. Your weekend goes well, and it's been going pretty well for Oklahoma today because the crystal balls are rolling in for Peyton Bowen to flip from Notre Dame to Oklahoma. Tomorrow night, Saturday night, Brent Venables will have the final in-home visit with Peyton Bowen. That's a good sign. But today's been like a good day. There's a lot of celebratory reactions, and I know, everyone's gonna go nuts, and you know, it hasn't happened yet. It's like, what about David Hicks and all that stuff? I get you, folks. You're going through PTSD. We all go through PTSD in recruiting. It happens. But this has been building up for the entire year, and I'm just glad we're finally coming to a satisfying conclusion, it seems. And I would love to tell you he's gonna make the announcement tomorrow or Sunday or Monday, but Wednesday is coming up pretty quick, where he'll sign the dotted line, and everything is pointing in that direction. So, crazier things have happened. I know people are worried about Oregon, but he's not making a trip to Oregon this weekend. So if you were worried about that happening, that's not taking place. Brent's going to have the last in-home visit, and that'll be that. So, still waiting on Tasilia Kana. I know Texas fans have some last-minute hope they can swoop in and get him, but the big outside linebacker defensive end from Utah, the big four-star top 100 player in the country, is trending towards OU as well. So at the moment, we got two big fish to hopefully wrap up this recruiting class, maybe a few other guys here and there. I know the portal is still being talked about. The portal still can be open after Wednesday, so we're still working on Trace Ford and a few other guys. Trace Ford will be a lot of fun if we can grab him, and it looks like that's potentially trending that direction too, so stay tuned on that. Okay, so a little recruiting update at the top of the video. Let's talk about moving to the SEC in 2024. I talked about it earlier this week, but we have some articles coming out now. And it seems to be both parties want this to happen. OU Texas wanted it to happen. The Big 12 wants it to happen. I guess you could throw the SEC in there, too. I know there's a handful of you who think there's a chance this will happen next year. It's not going to happen next year. It's way too late in the process. I know, in theory, if they absolutely had to, they could do it. But no one is going to move a mountain to make that happen in 2023. That hope died last summer. If it didn't happen last summer, it's not going to happen now. So you need a good 18 months minimum to make something like this happen, make it go smoothly. So prepare yourself for 2024. And it just makes more sense. You got USC and UCLA moving to the Big Ten at the same time, the expansion of the playoff, the video games coming back. It has really nothing to do with anything, but all things good things are going to happen in 2024, it seems. So, what are the holdups? I know the big holdup for a long time was like the buyout. Like, the buyout is going to be the same no matter if they leave early or if they wait it out till 24 or whatever. I know, like, the big $80, $90 million buyout, whatever it may be. That's not really the issue at this point. What the issue is I may have mentioned this earlier this week, is that TV inventory for Fox. Now, long story short, they don't want to lose potential big games involving Oklahoma and Texas they would normally expect for the 2024 season. So if we leave early, all of a sudden there's, you know, a hole in TV spots. They'll have Big 12 games, but they're not going to have the two biggest dogs in those games. They're not going to have a shot at OU Texas. They're not going to have a shot at any of the big Texas games non-conference or OU games non-conference. So believe it or not, we do draw a rating. We are a big part of what makes that thing go whatever. So what's being talked about? Well, Dennis Dodd at CBS posted an article just tonight and said something along the lines of possibly like a trade, a guarantee of games being on Fox. So what's kind of being preliminary discussed right now is potential non-conference games for OU and Texas on the road at Big 12 teams. So OU and Bedlam, Oklahoma State could potentially still happen, maybe. That's an idea that's being floated out there. You know, Texas TCU or Texas Houston, I'm just throwing out, or whatever. So Texas Baylor, Texas Tech, OU versus K-State, whatever. Just some games out there that would be familiar, but they would become, ironically, non-conference games. So maybe you can fill those holes for that season, or maybe a few more seasons down the road. So potentially as like a bargaining chip. So, okay, you let us go early, you'll have that TV inventory for 24 and maybe a couple years afterwards. So yeah, it would make sense for Bedlam to be on the docket potentially in Stillwater for some of those years, or however it may work. Now, again, from what's being reported is that this has been in the works for a little while now. Things got really rolling a few weeks back, and there was like a big meeting in Las Vegas. And it seems like, again, all parties involved want this to happen. So I think just a couple of backroom deals where a few handshakes and you make something happen, and then hopefully we'll hear something down the road sooner rather than later. It's kind of disappointing because we're not hearing, we're supposed to get the new schedule released like literally this week for the Big 12 season next year. But that's being pushed back to like early February from what it sounds like. So if you're wanting to know exactly when, who's going to play when, we're not going to get that till February. But alas, so we're not going to hear that anytime soon. Because if you know OU and Texas won't be there in 2024, they're probably going to make some changes to 2023. Because it sounds like to me, they want Oklahoma and Texas to play mostly Big 12 teams, if not all Big 12 teams on their schedule, because especially the road games, because those are the last chances those schools are going to have of hosting OU and Texas in conference play to get that ticket revenue. Because your team in the Big 12 might suck, but if OU and Texas come to town, our fans will come too, and you'll fill out your stadium quite nicely. So last chance for all the Kansas and K-States of the world and whatnot to get that shot in there, Iowa State, whatnot. So we'll see how that turns out. But till then, hopefully we'll have some more positive recruiting news over the weekend. But this is kind of it for visits, by the way. Like, as tomorrow, Saturday, is the last time coaches will be on the road, have visits. Then it comes down to Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, where you're just like hoping everyone holds on to the last second for all the guys you've got. Maybe you can flip some guys. It's going to be, it's a college football Christmas. What kind of gifts do we have under the tree? I cannot wait for December 21st. National Signing Day is one of my favorite days of the year. Sometimes there's some drama, and who knows what will happen. But right now, it sounds like OU will go from, right now, they're ranked number 8 in the 24/7 composite, and they could pop up as high as number 3 if they add guys like Akana and Peyton Bowen. So, and who knows who else they may grab the last second. So, anyway, just want to drop in with just my thoughts on that real quick, and hope everyone has a great weekend, and Boomer Sooner. Catch y'all later.